Good morning, dear students. In the chapter Protecting the Environment, so far we learnt about what is environment and how it's going to be get polluted, and it has types of pollution like air pollution. Air pollution occurs due to the dust, smoke, harmful gases which are going to mix up with the air, and it causes skin allergies, health hazards, and which will be due to the harmful gases. And it causes smoke due to the smoke released from the factories, vehicles, busting of crackers and cutting down of trees, etc. Then water pollution. It is substance which are going to mix up with the water bodies like rivers, lakes and oceans. They make water dirty, hence it becomes a water pollution. Due to this, why this water pollution occurs? Due to the dumping of garbages or domestic wastages into the sewage and festival waste into the water bodies. And next, soil pollution or the land pollution, which gets contaminated due to the waste materials thrown away in the landfills and due to the dumping of harmful and substances from the industries and the hospitals on the ground, and even the chemicals like fertilizers, pesticides, insecticides in the agricultural land, all those things. Noise pollution, excess use of the vehicles, so loudspeakers and even the bursting of large sounds, firecrackers, all those things creates noise pollution. So how do we manage these pollution and how do can we reduce the waste? So it has been classified into two waste. One is biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. So the things which are going to be easily get mixed with the soil, and like vegetable peels, leaves, paper, which are the naturally which can be degradable, is called biodegradable waste. The things which are takes long years to get mixed with the soil and thus remain in the environment for a longer period, it is called non-biodegradable waste. And generally we follow methods of disposing waste like dumping and landfill, burning and composting. But there are several there were several ways to manage this waste. And generally we have 3 R's in order to manage our environment. So let us see, that is reduce, reuse, recycle, how these three will be helpful in saving our environment, and we'll see in today's class. So the things that are of not use anymore is called waste. It's been classified into biodegradable waste and non-biodegradable waste. And generally we dispose the waste through dumping, landfill, burning, composting, but these are the not the proper way to dispose the waste. So reduce is nothing but it means that we must buy only those things which are essentially required. Unnecessarily we should not buy any things which are of no use. Many of the times when we go for the shopping, for the groceries and some other things for the home, we generally when we see the offer and we just get interest into that and we buy more than the requirement. So that we first, the best way to reduce our environmental pollution and is the things which are of no use and not necessary we should never buy, even though it is at less price or the discount or whatever it may be. It's just one of the way to attract the customers or the consumers. So we should buy the things only which are necessary and essential for our day-to-day life. This is one of the best way to reduce the waste. And it they are telling that we need to use and we need to buy really what is required. That is the true fact. Because unnecessarily we are buying the things and it will be kept over the at one place. And after some time it will be of no use and we just throw it. It may be eatable items or some other goods also. After some times it may be of no use. So in order to reduce the waste, before we buy, we have to rethink. So this will reduce the amount of waste which we create. So before reduce and reuse and recycle, in each and every aspect, we have to rethink whether it is required us or not. The next one is reuse. The word itself says that the reuse. Used things can be used once again. So the things which are primarily used can be used for the secondary purpose. So things that can be used for the secondary usage is called, one of the method in reducing the waste is reuse. Used things can be used for the one more time or two more times for further usage. That is reuse. So the things that can be used for secondary usage after the usage of its primary use, it can be used for the further usage for some other ways without wastage is called reuse. So reuse, instead of throwing like a certain old items like your books, stationery or the clothes and toys, you can donate to them some needy persons or from to some charities so that they can be used again. It reduces the waste also, it saves environment also, it increases our economy status also. So some things can be useful in different way. For example, they say this, from the old clothes we can make the toys, duster, and we can wipe it for the cleaning purpose. You can use the old clothes for the cleaning purpose also. For the decorative table clothes,